It's Chris's birthday, so let's sing. Let's sing happy birthday to Chris. He's 29, but I'm just tall as age right now. But let's sing. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Chris. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Every day of the year, may you find Jesus here. Happy birthday to you. A happy birthday to you. And the best year you've ever had. Amen. So happy birthday, Chris. And we're glad you and your mother could join us today. And you know what? God doesn't mess up. He always has a plan. Amen. So we're so glad to have you with us. So now, it's my great honor, my great pleasure to serve alongside of my mother, Pastor Fonda Hinkle, who served here with my father before me. And she is our ladies ministry director. And I support the ladies ministries. And so I want to turn it over to my mother to open up and to greet you today. So give Pastor Fonda a great big welcome.
I love how he's so supportive of the women's ministry. He just wants it to thrive and pushes it to go forward. And I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for all of you being here today. Welcome, welcome. And I know some are still on their way, but we're going to go on and get started. I wanted to thank everybody who's been so busy helping me put this together. Starting with Sister Mary Watts and Sister Barbara. She is our coordinator for the TLC soup kitchen that runs alongside of the Tabernacle. And her plate has been so full this time of the year. You can imagine the feeding of the poor and giveaways. She's been a very busy lady. And still, she had time to keep. Yes, we never did a winter tier. This was our first one.
Yay!
And so,
you guys started up from here. Oh, you guys got it matched up right here?
And Sister Barbara Young, who you'll be hearing a lot more from today, helped her with the food, getting it all ordered, getting it all here. Along with my mother, my sweet mother, always is so supportive. She was here last night with us as we were decorating, setting tables and so forth until late at night. And I think she still does it really well, getting around and doing for the Lord. And Sister Deb made all of the table centerpieces for us and helped with all of the other decorations. And Sister Michelle made the little favors you see to help me with the decorations as well. And we just had a really good time going up and down ladders yesterday. And Sister Leola, oh my, she surprised me. She'd get up on the ladders, but she did. And she was here until late last night when her husband finally called her home. Time for you to come home. It was kind of late for her to be out driving around by herself. But, you know, so much help with so many others, and I hope I don't forget anybody, but I appreciate each and every one of you. And I'm so thankful because God is so good. And, you know, we have another matriarch here in our midst, and that's Sister Martha Clucky. And I want to ask her to come and open this whole day in prayer, please. And I remember the first time she walked in here, she says, "Do you allow the Holy Spirit to move in this place?" I said, "Do we ever?"
It wasn't moving.
Praise God. It was black. Yeah, it's too hard to read on the
In the name of Jesus, we open this here gathering in Jesus' name, and we invite you, Holy Spirit, to move in this gathering. And we bless the moon, and we bless our conversation, and I pray that you will bless each one as they come here, Lord, and as they fellowship, and they will feel your presence in this place. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I'd like to welcome all the visitors that are non-attendees of Victory that are here from other places. I'm not going to try to name everybody because I get in trouble that way. But I recognize them, and I'm so thankful that you are here today. And now I think it's time for me to... bring up our mistress of ceremonies, Sister Barbara Young. This lady is a real doctor.
I appreciate you too.
Amen.
Okay, we're sorry we're so late, but we were waiting for some of you. We just waited for you because you're so special. And now, before I introduce our worship team, we do have this is wonderful. See, God has this all orchestrated. Hallelujah. Before I introduce a very special person, I just want to let all of you know we have raffle in this room. There's about 20 gifts. You put a ticket, you have some green tickets, and we have some yellow tickets. And they're different prices. Marcy, hold up your hand. Marcy in the back table, do you still have tickets?
I do.
Okay, she has tickets. And you know, maybe if I persuade Ariana, maybe she'll go around and give. If you need tickets right now, would you raise your hand? Oh, okay. Maybe Ariana, do you mind? I'm sorry to pick on you. Okay, throughout, when you're eating, whenever you want to do it, you have tickets that you can put in the little cups. And throughout the afternoon, we're going to raffle off the tickets. And see this 40-inch TV? There are raffle tickets for that. The yellow tickets are for the TV. The green tickets are for in this room. So be sure and cut off half of them for the ones in this room. And for the TV, it's a single ticket. Just put your name on it. Okay?
Okay.
Now, we have a very special guest while you're eating. He is awesome. I just can't say enough about him. Nick is a terrific singer. He's a man of God. He loves the Lord. And he's been professional, but you know, he loves to serve God. And so that's what he does. He serves the Lord with his music. And he blesses so many, and so many come to the Lord. Brother Nick, would you come and minister to us? He doesn't sing, he ministers. Don't forget that. Amen.
Thank you, Barbara.
Thank you, Barbara. Thank you, Barbara.
Somebody's already drunk in the spirit, I see. I'm sure that table will be rolling here in about 4 minutes.
I just told her she's nice, baby.
Everywhere she goes, she brings drunkenness with her.
Hallelujah!
Loro corpo sono la voce per mia patto dallo sapere. Priamo il corpo santo vero possiede il brano di scelta di mia patto dallo sapere. Brother Tim?
Yes.
The Spirit of the Lord says to you, for yet shall I move upon the face of the world and use you. With a mighty strong hand shall I go before you and prepare the way. The path will be cleared so that when you step forth, there already will be laid in place minds and hearts who are ready to receive. The harvest shall be great, the timing perfect and important, says the Lord. For I have called thee for such an hour as this. For I, by my mighty hand, shall show my great works forth in thee, and I will cause thee to rise above and to prosper greatly, and through thee will I proclaim my word as a shofar from the mount of God, says the Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord.
Look not to the right nor to the left. Look to neither side, and neither look behind thee, says the Lord. For I am before thee, and as thy eyes are placed upon me, shall I bring thee forth, says the Lord, in the holiness of my temple. The train of my temple shall fill every place where you walk, says the Lord. The train of my temple shall follow thee. Remember, remember, to unite with me and keep thine eyes forward, says the Lord.
Yes, hallelujah.
And just as Samuel went to the house of Jesse, and he said, show me your sons. God has said, look not on the outward, as he went to a Abimadab. He said, no, it's not him. And then Samuel went to the next son, and the Lord said, no, it's not him. And he went to the next son, and the Lord said, it's not him. Even Jesse didn't even know his own children. Even Jesse never said, yeah, I have a son out there tending the sheep. Samuel stood in front of all seven brothers, and the Lord said, it is none of these. He had to say, do you have another son? Is there another son? And it came to pass when they were come, and he looked on Eliab, and said, surely the Lord is anointed, is before him. But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance, nor on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. Then Jesse called, and they all passed before Samuel. And the Lord had not chosen these. And Samuel said unto Jesse, are here all thy children? Samuel had to tell him, are here all thy children? And he said, oh, there remaineth yet the youngest. And behold, he keepeth the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, send and fetch him, for we will not sit down till he come hither. And he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and withal of a beautiful countenance and goodly to look to. And the Lord said, arise and anoint him, for this is he. And the Lord said to Samuel, how long are you going to weep? For the anointing has left Saul. And not only has it left Saul, but now an evil spirit.
Thank you. It's a sound of many waters. It's a sound of worship. It's coming up from the throne. There are cries of adoration as men from every nation lift their voice to make your glories known. They're singing, holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. The elders and angels bow, the redeemed we worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. The elders and angels bow, the redeemed we worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
Holy, holy.
plead the blood of Jesus over every person's heart, their livers, their kidneys, intestines, every organ of their body, the blood of Jesus, joints, arthritis has to go in Jesus' name. Carotid arteries has to be freed up in Jesus' name. All infirmities into the dust in Jesus' name. We cast it out by the power of the blood. We cast it out by the power of the blood in the name of Jesus. You're the glory and the lifter of my head. Yeah, what's the sister's name again over here? Janet?
Oh, Kalita?
No, the tall one here.
Susan?
If you get a whim and it's in your key, grab a mic. Turn me down, please, and turn up the track.
You're my glory and the lifter of my head. You're my glory, Lord, and the lifter of my head.
The Lord's not done with you yet, Tim. There was a place and a time, says the Lord, when you were upon your face in the midst of where I did not want you. From that place, I have raised you up, and I will continue to raise you up. That place will no longer exist within you, says the Lord. Those things that were shall never be again, says the Lord. There shall be no traces, baggage, attacks, not even a remembrance of it, says the Lord. There will be those who will come from behind, and I say they shall not come. There will be those who will come from the left and from the right because of what is upon you, says the Lord. But I say to you, they shall not touch. That which is before you is the thing that I have planned and called you for. Your destiny, your fruitfulness, the calling, the anointing, and the prosperity are all ahead of you, says the Lord. Your eyes upon me and nothing else. In that place, says the Lord, what I have in store for you is beyond your imagination. It is beyond your scope and view of understanding, but you shall see it, says the Lord. You shall see these things come to pass. You shall know the work that I have truly placed within you, and you will wonder and marvel at my hand, says the Lord. I would be amiss if I left right now. Let's play me something. And then I have to go sing in the Christmas tree.
Blessing and honor and power, riches and wisdom to you.
Oh, the glory, would you mind? Hey, we're not done yet. We're just getting going. Because who am I? the anointing shows up.
We love you in the name of Jesus. Very few people enter into this holy of holies.
He has this place reserved for you. Yes, Lord.
Let there not be one person untouched when they go to do what it is you call them.
to do, let healing, virtue, sanctification, and the glory of your presence flow forth. The blood of Jesus. And that's all I have. Is that enough? Thank you for allowing me this time. I have to leave momentarily because I'm singing in the Christmas tree at Capitol. I asked one buddy Hookie to be here today, so they'll have to live without me. Is this for you, Barbara? Is that okay? Bless you.
Some of you that, well, Deb would probably explain that better than me, but it used to be a, I probably shouldn't be the one. It used to be women only, but now it's everybody.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's an international organization of prayer and intercessory. I'm sorry, I'm just doing it because you don't have a mic.
And anyway, and people, when they come together, there is a mighty move of God.
Amen.
And I would encourage women of you that haven't been attending and go anywhere to do so, because God brings some awesome people together. And you know, the Bible tells us not to forsake the gathering of ourselves together, even as we see the days approaching. And we need to do more and more.
Yeah. It's on the 19th at right here. 7 o'clock, Monday night. We have it once a month. Wow. I just don't know how to follow that. I know it's our worship team. Can we do it? Have all of you put in your raffle tickets in here?
No.
Where do we get raffles?
Anybody have not had a chance that wants to?
Yeah.
Okay, let's wait then. Let's have the worship team come up then. I was going to do a couple of comments, but we want all of you to have an opportunity. Are you glad you came? Oh, amen. And you know, while we have a minute, I would like to just thank Sister Mary Watts. She's done so much.
How much are the raffle tickets for the TV?
The raffle tickets for the TV, the yellow tickets only, are 1 for $5, 3 for $10, and 7 for $20. 1 for $5, 3 for $10, and 7 for $20. You don't need to buy them though, because mine's in here and I'm going to win. So we might as well forget it. Oh, it's not right? Oh. Oh, well. Praise the Lord. So tonight is a blessing. Amen. So we're going to sing along to some of the songs we've all known, and then we'll get into the programs that we have for tonight. God bless you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you.
there's no water. Ready, girls? Can I see a smile, girls? Listen, our audience, with your smile. Beauty that made this heart
Really minister. She's just awesome. Her bio was this long. She has served with her husband and now she's serving with her son. She's the lady that is our first lady, and I'd like to introduce her right now, Pastor Fonda.
Because of all of you. Amen. Praise God. Oh, I'm just so thankful this morning, this afternoon. I keep calling it morning. It's all morning to me. Praise God to me.
Yes.
Praise God. Morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Father, We just thank you for your spirit in this place. We thank you for the fun. We thank you for the lightheartedness. And we thank you because you minister to us in a deep and a real way. Lord, I just pray that I decrease, Lord, and that everything you want to say to these beautiful people today, God, you put on my heart to speak out, Father. In your precious name, Jesus, we just want you to have your way. We thank and praise you, Lord, for being in our midst. You know, we're blessed people to have the Spirit of God moving among us.
Amen.
You know what an honor that is. I mean, that's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. If the President were to walk in here, the President-elect, everybody would be just so clamoring for attention. But we have greater still. We have the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And he is truly the wonder of this time of the year. We decided to have this as a winter wonderland theme. And when we decided that, I thought, wow, Jesus is such a wonder for all time.
Amen.
And we can praise him and thank him because he's a mighty God. And I'm just so thankful to bring this to you this morning, this afternoon. It's morning again. Oh, praise God.
Good morning.
Ooh, hallelujah. We're talking about the wonder of ages, chosen from the foundation of the world. In 1 Peter 1:18, you know that you were redeemed from the futile way of life handed down from your ancestors, not with perishable things such as silver or gold, but with precious blood, like that of a lamb without defect or spot, the blood of the Messiah.
Amen.
He was chosen from the foundation of the world, but was revealed in these last times for your sake. Through him, you are believers in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your trust and hope are in God. You know, we have people here from many different cultures and many different walks of life. And God has claimed us all. And Jesus paid for us all. He redeemed us. Praise God. And it's because of that that we have a relationship with him. Praise God. He was chosen. And now that you have purified your souls in obedience to the truth, leading to sincere brotherly love, love one another fervently from a pure heart.
Amen.
You have been born again, not from perishable seed, Amen. But imperishable, through the living and enduring word of God. For all humanity is like grass, and its glory like a wildflower.
Hmm.
The grass withers and the flower falls off.
Mm.
But the word of the Lord endures forever.
Yeah.
And this is the word that was proclaimed as good news to Amen. You. Jesus became flesh and he dwelt among us.
Mm.
Emmanuel, God with us.
Mm.
John 1:14 says, and the word became flesh and tabernacled among us. We looked upon his glory and the glory of the one and only from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Mm.
Mm.
Oh my
goodness. Jesus was chosen. Then a voice in Luke 9:35. Then a voice came out of the cloud saying, this is my son, the one I have chosen. Listen to him.
Mm.
And he fulfilled prophecies. His event was prophesied. Some scholars say there were 353 prophecies of his coming life, and others attribute over 400 that he fulfilled. He didn't come to destroy the law, people. He came to fulfill it.
Amen.
Amen. He is a lover of our soul like we cannot believe. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
It was prophesied, for example, in Isaiah 7:14, Therefore, Adonai himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin will conceive. When she is giving birth to a son, she will call his name Emmanuel. Mm. Born in Bethlehem, Micah 5 and 2. Therefore, he will give them up until the time when she who is in labor has given birth. Then the remnant of his brothers will return to Ben-Israel. Benai Israel. My pronunciation is not always perfect, but it's not. Other events that were prophesied about him in Psalms 41 and 9. Something evil was poured into him. He will not get up again from the place where he lies. That was Judas's betrayal. The payment Judas received was prophesied in Zechariah. You know, all these things were prophesied many, many years before they came to pass. And it wasn't even possible for any human being to fulfill all of these things that were written by so many people and compiled into one word. Because the only one that could do it was the true and only Son of God. So Zechariah 7:12 says, indeed, they made their hearts as hard as flint, preventing them from hearing the Torah or the words that Adonai Shemot sent by his Ruach through the former prophets. Consequently, great wrath came from Adonai Shavuot. Prophecies fulfilled. Death on the cross. He said, no man takes my life, I lay it down. Right away, he didn't have to do it. He wanted to do it because of his great love for us. And in the miracle of the prophecies from the cross, that none of his bones were broken. Psalms 34 and 20.
Yeah.
And words he would say committing his spirit into the Father's hands were Psalms 31, 5. Lots were cast over his clothing in Psalm 22 and 18. We're told about this, what's going to happen. So we know when all of these things come true, we know that by reading the Gospels of what happened, what actually happened, lines up with what was told and prophesied about his coming and that he was fulfilling all of these things. There's so many more. I don't know how many I wrote down. Praise God. Next slide, please. Pleading for forgiveness for the ones who persecuted him. Amen. He said, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do.
Amen.
And then the darkness that would follow the death on the cross. In Amos 8, 9, it was foretold. And many, many more. If we just read those Gospels, you'll see how many are recorded and know all the wondrous things that he did for us. He was the wonder. He is the wonder. Praise God. He was tested. In Matthew 4, 1, we read, then Yeshua was led by the Ruach, that's the Spirit, into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. He didn't fail in any of those testings, by the way. And he was victorious. He performed many, many miracles while he was here. He turned the water into wine at the wedding in Cana. He healed the blind. He healed the lame. They went walking when they came to him. He fed the multitudes. He walked on water. He cast out demons. He calmed the sea. He raised the dead. And so many more things that he did. They said the volumes of the earth would never even hold all the things that he did while he was here because of his great love and his great power. Praise God.
Thank you.
Praise God. And so, he bled and died like he said he would. He rose from the dead on the third day. He was led to the cross where he bled and died. He was buried in a tomb never used before and rose again the third day. He was seen by many, over 500 witnesses saw him alive, and he ascended into heaven. But he didn't end there, people. Because now he's our high priest. Think about it. He sits at the Father's right hand and he makes intercession for us. In Hebrews 9:24 we read, "For Messiah did not enter into holies made with hands." You know, when the priests were here in the Old Testament and they would give sacrifices, they would have to go in once a year. And they have to repeat the sacrifices. But when Jesus went and he died and he gave his own self as a sacrifice, it was altogether different. It was outside of the realm of this earth. It was God's plan. For Messiah did not enter into the holies made with hands, counterparts of the true things, but into heaven itself, now to appear in God's presence on our behalf. Now he is our high priest. So when Messiah comes into the world, he says, "Sacrifice and offerings you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. But a body you prepared for me." That's what Jesus said to the Father. "And in whole burnt offerings and sin offerings you didn't delight. Then I said, behold, I come to do your will, O God. In the scroll of the book, it is written of me." Praise God. So we have a new covenant. And this is the new covenant. In Hebrews 10:16-17. This is the covenant. Covenant is a promise, and God never breaks his promises.
Amen.
And he says, "This is the covenant that I will cut with them. After those days, says Adonai, I will put my Torah upon their hearts, and in their minds will I write it. Then," he says, "I will remember their sins and their lawless deeds no more." So we are so free. We are free indeed. Hallelujah. Because he remembers none of our sins. He puts them in the sea of forgetfulness as far as the east is from the west. And they're not counted against us because he paid the price.
Hallelujah.
He made the sacrifice. He was our lamb. Praise God. He was the Lamb of God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. After he did all those things, he gave us a promise that he's going to come back and get us again, and he's going to bring his reward with him. He says, "I behold, I come quickly, and my reward is in my hand." So what we're to do is to occupy until he does, and keep us bringing our step, because we never know when it'll be that time, and we'll be caught up to meet him in the air. He says, "I'll show you a mystery. You'll not all sleep. You'll be changed immediately in the twinkling of an eye." And we're looking forward to that day, and we're looking forward to gathering ourselves together all the more in these days. And that's what today was all about, gathering ourselves together to worship the King of Kings and our Lord of Lords. Praise God. Did you prepare songs?
Well, I already did it with them.
Oh, you did it? Okay. All righty. I didn't want to forget anything.
Yeah.
Praise God. So I'll ask Barbara to come back.
All right.
We're going to have some more fun.
Go tell Barbara.
Thank you, Pastor Fonda. It's always what we need, huh? God is so good. And we do need to be ready when he comes, because it is going to be in a twinkling of an eye, and we never know when it is. It could be now. You know, you never know. When we least expect it, you're not going to know.
We have a
surprise. Oh, we have a surprise.
Pastor is going to do a song for us. Yes.
Oh, good. Okay.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Pastor's going to do a song for us.
Okay.
Ask what the Lord wants. God. So we're going to ask him to come right now.
Why
is he doing this? Well, I'm glad the Lord made this on his heart, because he's always blessing me. I love this song.
Thank you.
I rarely sing the song. I forget the words so often, so I have a printer. But it's one of Mom's favorites. And as she was, Pastor Fonda was ministering, the Lord quickened it to my heart. And a lot of it is symbolic because we know, the thing about this song, we know that believers are not going to be in the white throne judgment. I mean, we're already hidden in Christ. But besides that, this illustrates the point about how powerful the blood of Jesus is. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Ruach Kodesh. When I heard how do you plead, the accuser of the brethren was staring at me. He said, we've got your number, there is no escape. Here are your transgressions, your failures and mistakes. He pointed to the corner where the scales of justice stood. I saw so many failures there. There was nothing good. And in that very moment, when it seemed no hope was lost, I said, I plead the blood of Jesus. I'm dead of a breath, one drop of blood. He was defeated,
yes, he was,
by one drop of blood.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. A student watched in silence as others were let in. I saw them start to tremble when they turned to face their sin. They offered no excuses, they offered no advice. The truth was overwhelming, could not be denied. Their righteousness like filthy rags, and nothing they could say. They bowed their heads in silence as they were led away. But for the true believers, each time it was the same. His glory shone around them when they called upon his name. One drop of blood covered their transgressions. For all the times they failed, the enemy was mighty, came in like a flood. He was defeated by one drop of blood. Love.
He was defeated. Never my transgressions, for all the times I failed the enemy, he was mighty, treated like a flood.
A couple before nine. I have 413.
412.
No.
Is it me?
There's your purse. Get your purse.
I've got nails. No.
Okay, open it up, Martha. Let's see that $1 million thing.
You are the teapot.
Teapot coming up.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout.
Teapot. If you feel up to it, no pressure.
313.
It's like two wins now. I need some more wins. Come on, man.
Bingo.
Bingo.
I didn't see that. Cutting board.
Oh, I didn't see the cutting board. I need a cutting board.
Oh, no. I want that. That's a cheese board. Come on.
That's a cheese board. Sorry. It's got knives and everything. Wow. I'm going to hear all the
cheese. 290.
Okay.
291.
413. 413.
Oh, you already drew that one. You won the tape. 413. Hey.
All right,
next
time.
Didn't she already?
Yeah, no more. She got the good half. Wow, thank you. How are you? Okay. This is a food show. Oh, it's a food processor. Oh.
Is that the Cuisinart one?
Come on. Come on.
Is that the Cuisinart one? I can't
show.
Shake it up. That's not the boat one.
Who invited you anyway?
I thought this was a ladies' tea.
All right, but tell me I'm not shaking them up, so.
Yeah, shake them a little harder.
Put them in another container so you can drop it.
We're dicing food tonight.
I do. A deep fryer set.
I'm going to win this.
Okay. Nice.
What is it?
Come on, deep fryer set.
I love a deep fryer set.
That goes with your group. Okay, 434.
I got it.
434.
You got it. Who? Who?
Maybe not this one. That one probably.
That sounds bigger than from here. I got it. Who?
Should I just sit here and wriggle out? I'm going to win.
Is that the Cuisinart one? Is that the Boat Motor one?
Hamilton Beach Food Chopper.
Nope, that's not the one.
Come
I'm
on. 293.
Don't get away.
I have enough.
I have a one in
here.
Yeah,
I did.
Hold on. What's
more? Is it 393?
We're so lucky. You just said what?
410. 410.
Because I didn't.
That's a rifle. 410.
I'm just hanging up, man.
Just give up, Kevin.
I didn't put one in there for that one, though. So right?
That's what you want for somebody.
Yeah.
That's
not
the one I want.
I want the boat water one.
This might be open for betrayal. Let's just settle this all first. See what we're working with.
Okay,
it's a four-piece canister set.
I'm winning. I'm still winning.
304.
I think somebody said this earlier. 430.
I said 304.
I got it!
There's only one ticket in this one, so I can't mix it up.
Oh, it's gonna be me. It's gonna be me.
Dishes.
Thank you, Tilly.
159.
I'm gonna go over to
Tilly's
house.
159.
Tilly, you're gonna find out.
Not me.
Okay.
159. 159.
159. Yay! Jeb's got the one. Hey, Jeb. Give me good.
414
one,
one, one, one, one, one, one, one, one.
She's gonna need a truck to get out of here.
Yeah, Martha's gonna need a truck. Sister
Plexa. Come on. That's the one I want.
Okay, here's a hand blender.
Two,
it's a stick
hand blender. Oh, that's the one I want. I need
for sauces. A lot of tickets in here.
Okay, now I'm gonna win.
Pick the green one.
414 to 418. Any of that in that area?
No, Kevin.
Hey, I cook. I need that.
688. 306. 306.
You got it.
Yes.
You got it. Vince?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, Vince, you don't need that. You don't cook. You don't cook, Vince.
I don't think so. You are gonna need a truck too.
Vince, you don't cook. Don't eat it. Good cause.
People flow it. Yes.
We should
go stuff. The hydrator's coming out, so.
Stir them! Get that one!
Four.
One.
Don't you get
one.
Up.
Three. No.
I'm not picking up. You are.
You have to tell us.
You're the one picking up.
I'm not going to
tell
you.
Kelly again. I put three tickets in there for that. That's why I wanted it.
Yeah, the TV. I'll all take right, all this. He wants to trade for the TV.
No way.
Now, since it's late.
It's a new wave oven. Think or a food product.
Oh my God, my mom was a bit puppy of me.
Is there a price?
Oh, is there a price for the door price?
No.
No, there wasn't.
Who wants a door?
There is. I've got it in my wallet.
Oh! You collected it for a souvenir. No, I'm just kidding.
Green ticket?
I hope you guys know I'm kidding. Some of you that don't know me don't know I'm kidding. I'm really kidding. Yeah,
I'm telling her I'm
kidding.
Okay,
what is this? This is the door
prize.
Okay.
Who wants the door? There's a few
more
doors in my house.
Susan.
Yay, Susan!
Woo! She has a long way to travel.
That's right. Yes. I decided it was before I pray, I'm really privileged and honored to be here. And when the message came, Janet said in it, come to the tea party, you're a family. And for some of you who doesn't know me, I come from a Muslim background, and the first thing that happened to us when we receive God, we lose our family.
Yeah.
And then God replaced that family with the godly family, which is this family. So I'm really privileged and honored to, you know, to be here. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, so I'm privileged and honored. And Lord, I just thank you for family. I thank you that you put us together. Thank you, Lord, that you came from your glory to be an infant and to be a baby, God, and to give us life and give us life abundantly, Lord. And I just thank you that we are one in you. We are family. And thank you for all the celebration, all the joy, all the laughter, all the beautiful things that happened this season. And this year is special because Hanukkah is going to be on Christmas Eve.
Yes.
And it just, they smack dunk together this year. So it's really, really beautiful what you're doing, God.
Yeah.
Lord, we're just waiting for you to return. I feel like it's coming soon that you're going to return. But you asked us, as Pastor Vonta said, to occupy, to live, to be joyful, to be strong in you, to be one in you, and to wait for you. So we are waiting for you, and we're celebrating you, Father. We just thank you and praise you for all this beauty that you have given us. And Lord, we lift up all the families that have a brokenness in this season. Maybe there is death, maybe there is divorce. There is maybe people who are sick in the hospital. Lord, you come to them by your Holy Spirit. You bring comfort in a way that no one could bring, God. So we just thank you for joy, even in the midst of darkness. Thank you, Father. We praise you and thank you. And I just celebrate everyone here in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
To be on the roads tonight. Just, Father, we thank you because you care for us. We thank you for your angels, Lord. You are the captain of the host. And we ask you to put angels around about and guide and direct and keep safe, Father, as they're on their journeys, Father. And that you, oh God, maybe even bring somebody into their path that needs your light and your salt. And Father, on the way, Father, that they can be a blessing. And we thank you, Father. We thank you for being with us every day. We don't have a special time or a place where we can call on you, but we can call you anytime and anywhere. And we pray. Thank you, Father, for your many, many blessings on these lives. Father, for each one that's here tonight, Father, for a covering over their families, Father, of protection. And, Father, for health to spring forth. And we give you the praise in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus. Yeshua HaMashiach. Jesus, our Messiah. Hallelujah. Pastor.
And somebody mentioned Hanukkah. We are going to have a Hanukkah party.
Oh, we are?
Yes, we do. We have a Hanukkah party, and it is on, I think, the last part of Hanukkah. It's on the New Year's Eve. We have to look at the calendar. Where's our calendar at? Okay. Okay. I'm going to take it to my phone. Who has a December calendar for the church? Oh boy. Pastor Fonda's going to tell you a couple things, and I'm going to be right back and tell you a date.
I'm going to tell you a couple things. Jesus loves you. He loves you lots, and he loves you. And he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and I love him so much.
Yeah.
He's going to come back with his calendar to see when he has actually scheduled the Hanukkah party. Oh, it's a fun thing.
Good job.
We can celebrate the light of the world. That's what Jesus is, light of the world. And you know, when you look at the menorah and the Hanukkah, it's got the one
tower. I know.
The Hanukkah. is higher than the others. That's because Jesus is higher, and he touches on all
empty bottles. Empty bottles.
You're done with that one? Oh, Helena. We have one big happy family here, and everybody here is family. Pastor Joy, thank you for being with us.
On the 31st. And we have latkes and jelly donuts and we dance and we talk about Jesus on Hanukkah. We have latkes. And it's free. 10 o'clock.
Don't forget Hanukkah miracles.
And we're going to have a Hanukkah miracle. Yes, we're going to share it with
life.
So join us. It'll be our second Hanukkah party, and it's on New Year's Eve at 10 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, day. New Year's Eve day.
We held on.